The Luma key within Final Cut Pro is easy to use, but there are a bunch of advanced functions, so let's show you what each one does.
If you haven't yet, please watch our previous video on the basics of Luma keying. Here, we have this logo, and the Luma keyer effect is applied with a few basic tweaks. Let's use the advanced controls to improve our Luma key. We'll select the foreground clip, then navigate to the inspector on the top right. If the inspector is not visible, click on this icon, and then click on the video icon. Let's check out the matte tools first. These tools allow us to refine the accuracy of which areas are transparent. When using matte tools, be sure to switch to matte view. The matte is pretty much already accurate, but we'll try to tweak these to see how they affect the results. Fill holes helps fill any areas that are partially transparent. In our example, it's doing more harm than good, so we'll set it to a low value. And edge distance determines how close to the edge fill holes is applied. Levels will edit the contrast of the key. The goal is to make the white of the subject as sharp as possible compared to the black background. This means our logo is as visible as possible, without any of the background to show through. Shrink and expand manipulates the contrast of the mat to adjust the sharpness of the edge. Soften allows us to feather the edges of the mat. Since it's a logo, we prefer it to be sharp, so we'll reduce soften to zero. And erode allows us to increase the transparency from the edge of the key inward. We'll leave that at zero as well.
Seems difficult, but once you get it, it's not really that much of a problem.
Next, we'll explore the light wrap controls. Light wrap is a way to blend our subject with the newly inserted background. This control is epic for making your composites more realistic. We can adjust the amount, which determines how dramatically the layers blend together. Intensity adjusts the sharpness of the edge, by determining the contrast between light and dark values. Opacity fades the light wrap effect up or down depending on the slider's value. And finally, mode allows us to choose a compositing method that blends the background values with the edges of the keyed subject. It's best to flip through these and see which one works best for your particular Luma key. We'll go through how each of these actually functions. Normal will evenly blend light and dark values from the background layer with the edges of the keyed foreground layer. Lighten will compare overlapping pixels from foreground and background layers, then preserve the lighter of the two. Screen will superimpose lighter portions of the background over wrapped areas of the foreground. Overlay combines the background with wrapped areas of the foreground, so that dark portions get darker, lighter portions get lighter, and colors become intensified. And finally, hard light, which is similar to overlay, except colors will become muted rather than intensified. Our key is nearly finished, but stay tuned for our video about using masks with keys, where you will see the finalized results.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment below, share, everything else you possibly can to spread the word that Pixel Film Studios creates awesome free tutorials for Final Cut Pro.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.